Hey guys, welcome back to a brand new video, and in this video we are going to go through my lineups for game week 293 and also go through my lineups for the upcoming midweek. So let's jump right into it. As you can see here, I won nothing this game week. I am very disappointed by my teams. And as you can see here, my cap to 40 limited was so close to hitting something very, very big. Only 5 points away from the ETH threshold. With the goal that Club Brugge scored was a penalty. And Rob Skufs got a downgrade of 30 points. Or I think he got... Yeah, because of a foul. And also because... the decisive got removed, yeah, so 30 minus. And also we lost the clean sheet on Gaetan Kocs and Jordi Vanlerberge. So we could have probably won a decent reward at high tier 5 or tier 4 if that wouldn't have happened. So I'm very disappointed by that. And yeah, I mean that wasn't a penalty. Yeah, if you want, you can go on Twitter and see it yourself, but I think it's so ridiculous to give away a penalty in that way. And also, it's so sad that one of my players so, yeah, that was very disappointing. But hopefully, this team can do wonders in the future. So... this was also a very hard game for Mechelen. So if we just go to one of the players and see... yeah, the next game is up against Ghent. And then I think it's against a team that is newly been promoted. And then Union Saint-Gilloise, very hard opponent. And Westerlo Eupen. And yeah, I just hope that Mechelen can... do better, but for all sake, I think Mechelen did a very good job against Club Brugge. But I have no idea why they're so keen on playing out of the back when Club Brugge had a high press. Gaetan Kocs, if we just go on him, on his SO5 scores, I can show you here. He got general, yeah, error led to shot. It was so stupid. He just passed it and he was pretty lucky and he did a very good save to make up for it. But moving on, I hope this team can do wonders in the future. Moving on, we have the biggest disappointment of the week by far. Fortaleza. Juan Luquero, in my opinion, one of the best players in the Fortaleza squad, got benched. Probably because they have a Copa Sudamericano I think in some days, or I know they have, but that could be a reason. Thomas Pochettino, okay. Titi, not the best, but they let in 3 goals, so I can't expect a good score. Pacheco did very well, despite him almost having not a lot of possession lost, but letting in 3 goals. And also João Ricardo did a very good job, 8 saves, but very unlucky with the last goal being in the 92nd minute. But either way, it didn't make up for it at all, because I don't think we ever would have got a reward either way, so I'm not that sad about that. But I just hope the Fortaleza boys can get their shit together. So that would be very nice indeed. And moving on, we have the cap 220 lineup with Stefan Kleveland letting in 4 goals, 5 saves, and a decent score actually. Dimitri Lavalli with a 40-pointer against Club Brugge, decent. Geoffrey Hermans, coming off the bench, 17 AA points in 20 minutes, very nice. And also Thiago Gallardo, I have no idea why he's starting over Luquero. The best thing is if both players plays, but I have no idea why Thiago Galhardo is preferred over Juan Luquero. And yeah, that's it. Very, very bad game week for me. Very unlucky, I personally believe I was. So we can go to the next week's lineup builder. 2 seconds. Game week 394. We have two teams. Fortaleza have a game week. So they are playing against a team I have no idea about. It's Libertad. We can go on Play Sharper and check the players. Yeah, we can Conmebol Sudamericana. And if we go here, we can see. Oh, okay. Oh, this is terrible because this is a nightmare for me because I have no idea who is going to start and who is going to get benched. So, Thomas Pochettino, Iago Pikachu 50-50, Kalebe, Lucas Sasha, Jose Wilson. Okay, so I don't have Caio Alexandre. I need to just check something real quick. Caio Alexandre. Let's just check his price. $3.4. Some is expecting him to not play at all, so okay. Okay, wow. 17 guesses for him to be out of the squad. And Play Sharper has him for 90%. Okay, so that's a bit strange, I believe. So I need to do some research on that. But I, either way, I don't have him. But I can just check his SO5 scores. Yeah, he did play last game, but did he get a yellow card or something? No, he didn't get a yellow card. So I have no idea why he shouldn't be playing. But, yeah. Moving on, we can see that the odds is... where can we see the odds again? No chance for him again. No, for me for now, but this probably doesn't. Okay, sorry for being quiet. Yeah, here we go. So the odds for Fortaleza victory isn't good, to be honest. But and also Bruno Pacheco is only 60% to start. Yeah, that's not the best, to be honest, but moving on here, I think we probably should just stick with this lineup and hope for the best. We could also make some changes here, for example, taking in Titi for Bruno Pacheco, because Bruno Pacheco isn't nailed. And also Pochettino is only 50% to start here. But when we go on here, we can see that every one of these is almost 100% nailed to start. So in most cases, Play Sharper use only one person to make a lineup. And that one person isn't necessarily an expert. But here we have almost 53 people is voting that they are 100%. So... just please leave in the comments if you have any inside information in the Fortaleza squad. That would be much appreciated. Moving on, we have the Academy lineup. Hopefully we'll hit the $5 threshold. That's also the goal in Cap 240. We have David Marshall, rare card. I have more than 10 rare cards, so that's why I didn't put this lineup in kickoff. But I'm very glad I could get some utility off David Marshall, and we can see that he is 97% chance of starting, so that's very good. And moving on, we can also see his rare price, 230. Yeah, he is on the horizon of being the starter goalkeeper for the Hibs, the Hibernian team. Here we can see an offer for $10.6. That's a very good price, actually. I'm very tempted to buy his limited card just for this weekend, actually. to use the rest of the players in Cap 2 or All Stars. But I don't think I'm going to do that. But I find it very weird that it's one up to $10, and for 30 minutes ago, some guy bought him for almost $13. But moving on, we have TT. Yeah, he's probably going to be in this team, to be honest, and with Jose Velison being 82% to start, Thiago Gallardo being 98% to start, and Yago Pikachu being 77% to start. So I would be very happy if I could just get the threshold with this team. Yeah, so this is probably going to be the lineup for Fortaleza. Yeah, it doesn't make too much sense because in this team right now they have zero wingers. Bruno Pacheco isn't a winger, he's a left back. So if they play three at the back, this could be the formation, but I don't think this is going to be. If they play 4-3-1-2, this could be the formation. I haven't watched too much Fortaleza, so I have no idea if that is going to be the formation. But that is probably going to be my lineups for this week. I've also made some changes in my club. I can just show you that really quick. We can just show you these new signings on the first page. And we will, of course, make a more in-depth video about more of my collections and the signings. So stay tuned for that. We have signed Josh Sargent for... because I'm a little bit tempted to buy Second Division Europe Limited, and also a bit tempted to play under 23 next season. And I also think he links up very good because I'm probably going to buy Angus Gunn as well. If we go on here, he's the last goalkeeper I'm going to sign before the start of the new season, but he's extremely expensive. Like, he sold for around $35 for a week ago or something. And now he's just, because it's under a week to his first game. So if I get him for like $46 or $45, I will be very happy. And I'm also very tempted to just buy David Marshall or something. With him being, he has decent fixtures actually. He has actually pretty good fixtures, it's not that fun to have both David Marshall limited and rare when you don't know if he's going to get dropped or not, because he's pretty old, and Valo Casa, I believe, his backup goalkeeper's name is. So I'm not sure, but I either want a Scottish goalkeeper from the Scottish League, and also, or also a keeper from the second division in Europe, for example, most likely in the championship, the England championship. And moving on, we bought Lisandro Martinez. I think I got him for a pretty fair price, to be honest. I got him around under here. Yeah, $40 for him. Pretty happy about that. I got pretty good percentage bonus on him as well, like 7.5 or something. I believe he's going to do very well next season, and I will fit him in the Champion Europe team. Moving on, we have Jan Oblak. I think I probably overpaid a bit for him, if we can... let me check... No, actually, I underpaid a bit for the last... Yeah, so I got him for a very fair price, actually. Sorry. Very happy about that, and... Like, I'm going to have a so good lineup for the first game week of the season against Granada at home. I'm going to have Oblak against Granada, and then my United boys against Wolves at home. So I think I could do very well, and I will probably line them up in All-Stars or Champion Europe. I'm not sure, but we will see when the deadline comes. But I'm also a bit tempted to just buy Grbic, his backup goalkeeper, just in case if Oblak gets an injury. Because it's a lot of money paying for him maybe getting an injury and destroying one of my lineups. Moving on, we have Lucas Crispim that I just bought because he's a jersey mint. Getting some experience to the collection bonus. Marcelino Nunes is a new signing. He has risen a bit in price, I believe. I bought him here and now he's risen a bit. He's 6, yeah, not that much, but I don't think he's going to start, but he is a very fun player to watch when I have watched him. And yeah, hopefully he's going to get more game time at Norwich this season. And also I got him for, I bought him out of the auction market, and also to have a under 23 option for next season with Josh Sargent, and also getting a bit experience on Josh Sargent and maybe Angus Gunn if I buy him. And I also bought Scott McTominay just for the experience, and also because I believe he can get a move in the winter or now. But yeah, I bought him for a pretty fair price here, we can see. But I'm not sure about Scott McTominay. He can... I will be very happy if he moves. And I will be very happy if he stays, because I'm a Manchester United fan. I love watching Scott McTominay play. And I think if he gets his shit together at the club, he will deliver very well. And he also have international. Yeah, he has UEFA Euro 2024 qualifiers in game week 405. I have no idea why I couldn't say that word. And also we have a Sevilla stack, and I will make a specific video about that, why I have that, and talk more general about that. And also, if we go on his SO5 scores, we can see that. Okay, I have no idea why Morocco isn't coming up. Just let me check Matt Turner. Matt Turner is, he has risen very much in price. Okay, yeah, I have no idea why it is coming up that they have international fixtures, because, or is it just because if we see here with Martinez, Emiliano Martinez, we can see that they have, yeah, they have utility in game week 405 and 406. So I'm not sure if this is only World Cup qualifiers. Just let me check 2 seconds, because Morocco. Oh, it's Africa Cup. It's not World Cup. Okay, sorry. Never mind. So I don't have any utility for him. But thank you so much for watching the video. Very disappointed this week with the lineups. I feel I was very unlucky. I see bright on the future. This is the first week where I played 2 lineups, and the first week with the Mechelen boys, and they delivered, had a very, very hard fixture, but they didn't win anything, unfortunately. But I'm very, very disappointed with the Fortaleza boys, but we of course hope they can deliver in this midweek, and I will of course see you in the next one. Take care and bye bye. Peace.